Niasse Academy of Architecture was established in the year 1999 as a standalone institution imparting architectural education under the auspices of the Miyassi Trust. Muslim Educational Association of Southern India, a 104-year-old trust.
The board of trustees are management, chairman, Janab Nawab Mohammad Abdul Ali Azimja, His Highness the Prince of Arcot, a well-known, highly respected and committed social activist involved in many social, cultural and religious institutions in the country. Honorary Secretary, Janab Elias Seth, a chartered accountant by profession and a businessman. Honorary Treasurer, Janab Najmuddin Majid, a very active and prolific businessman. The prime movers of our academy, Director Professor N. Altaf Ahmed, Dean Dr. A. N. Sachidanandan, Principal Dr. Monsingh David Devdas, and HOD Professor S. Kesavalu. The greatest core strength of the academy lies in the vast professional and academic experience of the spearheads, our director, dean, and HOD, with several decades of unstinted and dedicated contribution to the larger cause of architectural education.
Located within New College campus, in the heart of Chennai city, the academy has the approval of the Council of Architecture and is affiliated to Anna University, Chennai. The academy offers an undergraduate course, BArch, with a current intake of 160 students and two PG courses with an intake of 20 students each, one MArch General and the other MArch Real Estate Development. As part of the core faculty, the academy has three former deans from the architecture school at Anna University and senior practicing professionals as design chairs. Team of highly qualified and experienced faculty from across India and abroad, from US, UK, and Netherlands, with specific domain expertise.
The Academy has the largest team of 73 full-time faculty with domain expertise in varied dimensions of architecture, planning, landscape, sustainability, conservation, building sciences, and project management.
The Institute has a memorandum of understanding with Westminster University, UK, and has collaborated on the Latitude project with several premier institutions abroad, from Maldives, Colombia, and Italy, to name a few.
NYASI Academy of Architecture is growing from strength to strength. From its inception in the year 1999 until now in its 23rd year, in providing value-based architectural education that promises to create mature professionals with strong ethics, dedication, and commitment to the larger cause of the society. Our students have won awards, citations, and accolades at competitions. First place at National Level Heritage Documentation Awards. First place exemplary performance at competition by Square Factor. Second place at National Level Society Interiors. And four coveted prizes at the International Fabrication Festival, held among 33 global teams, hosted by Westminster University, UK. Our faculty are actively involved in paper publications in renowned journals, indexed journals, and also have taken part and presented at national and international level conferences and seminars. The Sonoris series has been initiated from the year 2021, a series of talks held once every month to further exchange of knowledge, interaction with experts in practice and academics from India and abroad, well beyond the domain of architecture. the collaborative program Global South to South with University of Johannesburg and the institutions at Nairobi and Nigeria have further initiated exchange of knowledge between the two institutions through seminars and presentations by faculty on either end. MIASI Academy of Architecture is extensively involved in institutional consultancy projects and with the Thanjavur Convention Center as part of Thanjavur Smart City Limited being the latest addition.
Invocation. A very warm welcome to one and all. Let us start this Induction Day event by seeking blessings from the Almighty. We will now begin with the Kirat.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
We will now have the Tamil Thai Vaazhthu.
நீராறும் கடலுடுத்த நிலமடந்தை கெழிலொழுகும் சீராறும் மதனமென திகழ்வரதர் கண்டமிதில் எக்கணமும் அதில் சிறந்த திராவிடனல் திருநாடும் தக்க சிறு பிறை முதலும் தரித்தனரும் திலகமுமே அத்திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இன்பமுற எத்திசையும் புகழ் மணக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழடங்கே தமிழடங்கே உன் சீரிழமை திரம்பியந்து செயல் மறந்து வாழ்த்துதுமே வாழ்த்துதுமே
A very good morning to all the students, parents, and all the respected dignitaries. It gives us immense pleasure to welcome you all to the 23rd Induction Day program at MIASI Academy of Architecture. Welcome address by our Honorable Director, Professor N. Altaf Ahmed. Professor N. Altaf Ahmed has been a dedicated academician, extremely sincere in his profession and a man of principles and conviction. Backed with 5 decades of professional practice and academic experience in India and Middle East, and especially teaching at university level, his unblemished record of more than 20 years of leadership at MIASI Academy of Architecture needs special mention. Professor Altaf Ahmed's vision for teaching, which is not confined to classroom alone, is evident from the fact that he has made valuable contribution as Chairman, Board of Examinations, Member of Syllabus Committee, Member, Board of Studies, Anna University, Member Board of Architectural Education, the Indian Institute of Architects, Convener of Inspection Committee for Council of Architecture. He has received the following awards: Best Teacher Award by the Indian Institute of Architects, Tamil Nadu, 2011, Fountainhead Lifetime Achievement Award, 2012, by Council of Architecture, New Delhi, Dr. Radhakrishnan Teaching Excellence Award, 2013, IIA Madhav Achwal Gold Medal, December 2016, in recognition and appreciation of his outstanding contribution to the field of architectural education. We now invite our director, Professor N. Altaf Ahmed, to deliver the welcome address.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Respected President Nawab Muhammad Abdul Ali Azim Jah, the Prince of Akkad, respected Secretary Janab Ilyas Seth, beloved Vice President Rafiq Ahmed, Honorary Treasurer Janab Najmuddin, Guest of Honor Architect Vijay Sohani, my fellow architects, fellow faculty members, dear students and parents. It's indeed a pleasure to welcome you all to Miyasi Academy of Architecture, where you're going to spend next 5 very important years of your life. I would like to congratulate you for choosing architecture as your profession, and also your parents for motivating you to select architecture as future career. Having been in the profession for the last more than 50 years, I can assure you that it is a very interesting, challenging and creative profession. You have been to schools, gone through courses. Now you have come to us to learn architecture. The main difference of learning architecture is, in our college, in our institution, that is what I strongly believe, that you can't teach architecture to everyone the same way. Being very creative, we should never lose that creative part of learning. So, instead of teaching, we try our best to help you learn. How do you learn? You learn through the classes, through your faculty members, library, and also what you see, what you read outside. Everything put together helps you learn architecture in a better way. You have chosen Miyasi Academy of Architecture for this purpose. Yes, we will do our best to provide you the quality education. But at the same time, I expect each one of you to put in all effort to learn properly. Believe me, I will not hesitate to help a person who is not very smart in academics, but I will not tolerate any indiscipline. I would like to assure the parents, especially parents of the girl students, that we will take all care so that there is no room for any complaint or anything else. If there is a problem, I request the students as well as the parents, you can always walk into my room and tell me if there is a problem. We'll solve it. We are there to help you. We'll put in all our effort to teach your children to become good architects. Architecture is a very wonderful profession. It's very creative. When you look at the architecture of a particular period, it reflects the socio-cultural, economic aspects of that particular time. Most of the buildings that were designed in earlier years, it was based on the grammar of architecture. I'm not too sure. After spending so many years in teaching and profession, whether the same principles are being followed by the new architects. Yes, the technology has come into building. And many sophisticated buildings are also coming up. But at the same time, architects are taking care that the creativity is not lost. You get buildings which are technologically sophisticated, but at the same time very creative, aesthetically pleasant, functionally correct. So it's a very nice opportunity for you to learn so much. Architecture deals with the human life. And it changes, it adapts itself as the human life changes over a period of time. It's something which you'll enjoy. You'll enjoy learning and you'll enjoy working as an architect. So, you have chosen a good profession where you'll be taught so many subjects, right from architectural design to economics, sociology, landscaping, town planning, and services. So, we make you into a complete personality. An architect, when he goes out of the institution, he knows or he has the basic knowledge of every aspect of building and design. We have an excellent faculty, full-time and part-time put together. We've got almost 100 people. 100 highly educated faculty members to help you learn. This, I'm sure, no other college has. So you have come to a right place to learn architecture. The management, our president, the Nawab, is very keen and never hesitates to help the students. But he is very firm in keeping up the standard of education. Our students have done well. Many have got many awards. Even at the national level, we have won some awards. Why? National level. Even at the global level, we have won some awards. We have a tie-up with Westminster University, London, and also with some of the African universities, where we participate in interactive classes. So, we have a good ambience, good infrastructure, and good faculty. What more can you ask for? And you can learn a lot from interacting with your seniors. This is another very important thing. When I was doing architecture 50 years back, we did not have many qualified teachers. But we learned many things from our seniors. So, dear students, take care. Learn to manage your time, which is another very important aspect of architecture. Because in the beginning, especially in the first year, you might find the pressure is a little too much. It's a question of learning to adjust your time. Once you do that, then you'll be comfortable. We'll be very strict in following up the schedules and make you work hard. Mind you, all this, we are doing it for your sake. I want the students and parents to appreciate this. You see, we can also sit and relax, but we don't do that. We put our heart and soul to help each child to learn. Why? For their sake. We don't get any benefit out of it. It is they who will benefit when they go to the college. But what do we expect in return from the students? Good performance, laurels to the institution. So, this is all I wanted to tell you. And apart from that, I would also like to say a few words about the guest of honor we have today, architect Vijay Soni. He is the former president of Council of Architecture, and during his tenure, we got many deserving benefits. I was very comfortable with him, and highly respected, accepted, and friendly person he is. Ever smiling, but very firm in his action. He will be speaking to you in the later part to motivate you to do architecture. As long as human beings are living in this planet Earth, there will always be a need for an architect. Why Earth today talks are there to construct human facilities on Moon and Mars? Even in that, architects will play a part. So, the opportunities are plenty. Subject is very interesting. It's up to you as to how you are going to make use of this to become a recognized, famous architect. I wish you all the best, and may Almighty bless you all. I wish a very interesting, creative, eventful, and purposeful 5 years in Miyasi Academy of Architecture. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the welcome address.
Inaugural address by our Honorable President, His Highness Nawab Mohammad Abdul Ali Azimjah, Prince of Arcot. Born in the Royal House of Arcot, His Highness Nawab Mohammad Abdul Ali Azimjah is the eldest son of His Highness late Nawab Ghulam Mohammad Abdul Qadir Azimjah, the then Prince of Arcot. The Nawab, who is very active in social and public life, is a well-known peace activist and is involved in many social, cultural, educational, and religious organizations. He is also the president of Muslim Educational Association of Southern India, Miyasi Trust. We invite our Honorable President, His Highness Nawab Mohammad Abdul Ali Azimjah, Prince of Arcot, to give the inaugural address.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our respected Honorary Secretary, Janab Ilyas Sheikh Sahib, respected Honorary Treasurer, Janab Najmuddin Sahib, our respected Vice Presidents, particularly our Janab T. Rafiq Ahmed Sahib, Miyasi Academy Architecture Director, Professor Altaf Ahmed Sahib, respected faculty members, all the board members, dear brothers and sisters. Today is a very good occasion of education of the new students in our Miyasi Academy of Architecture who will be joining to study architecture. Miyasi Academy of Architecture, who will be joining to study architecture, I greet all students. I greet the parents, the guardians of other children, of their children, for having admitted their children in Miyasi Academy of Architecture. By the grace of Almighty Allah, God, one of the best institutions in India and one of the leading top institutions in the state of Tamil Nadu, and it is a very popular name, Miyasi Academy of Architecture, across the world, almost. We have a good faculty members fully dedicated to teaching the students. My request to my new and old students who have joined to pay more attention to your studies. Architecture is a very fine line of education, and inshallah, you will be one of the top architects not only in India, you should also be internationally known. Yes, this is a moment of joy and pride for you. No doubt, my dear student, some of you might have felt excited, some of you might have felt scared for having joined this line of studies, and I'm sure it will be a very fine task for you to complete your course and become a great leader in the field of architecture. You have an excellent director, a learned and seasoned professor, Altaf Ahmed Sahib, and equally good faculty members, experienced in teaching life. They ensure that our students rank the best in the country. My dear students, you must always remember in your life that discipline is the most important. The conduct and character is most important. There is a very famous saying that three things we have to remember in life. If wealth is lost, nothing is lost. If health is lost, something is lost. If character is lost, everything is lost. I wish all my new students who have joined the best in your studies and all success in your studies. Please serve the nation, serve the society, and please respect your parents and teachers at every stage, so that tomorrow your children, your friends and your well-wishers will respect you, and don't forget to follow all government norms of this pandemic. With these words, I once again wish you all happiness and success in your studies. Be one of the best architects in the country and do designing of structure like in many foreign countries. You see beautiful structures, so why not in our great secular country, India? Why not in Chennai? See that good structures, good buildings comes up and the name and fame of our Miyasi fly high. With these words, I say once again congratulations to all of you and wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir, for the inaugural address.
Motivational address by Honorable Secretary Janab Ilyas Seth Sahib. Janab Ilyas Seth Sahib is the Managing Director of Alsa Marine and Harvest Limited and also the Secretary General for Seafood Exporters Association of India since 2005. He has over 30 years of experience in the fields of commercial transport, leather, and seafood. Currently, he is the Secretary of Muslim Educational Association of Southern India, MIASI Trust, and actively involved in various other educational and social organizations as well. He is a chartered accountant by qualification. We request our Honorable Secretary, Janab Ilyas Seth Sahib, to deliver his motivational address.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning to all of you. I welcome all the students who are coming in with a lot of hopes to the MIASI Academy of Architecture. Naturally, there will be hopes from you, from your parents, for all the efforts that you all have put in, that your parents particularly have put in, that to get you all admitted in this institute, the MIASI Academy of Architecture. Now, I don't want to say that you're lucky to get in the institute and you have had the good opportunity, fortunate, all that is on one side. But first and foremost, almost all of you have got into this institute, which is so very well recognized in not only in Tamil Nadu, but all over India, as being among the top 3 or 4 institutes of the country for architecture. All these build-up has not happened in a day. I think this institute is in existence for almost 25 years, and that reputation has been built up step by step in these 25 years by the management of MIASI. MIASI, you all have to understand, is the MIASI Educational Association of South India, which has in its wings New College with about 7,000 students, MIASI Academy of Architecture, of course, you have got about 800 students. We have MIASI Institute of Management, we have MIASI Institute of Technology, MIASI College of Education, and also we have a school with 1,400 students running in one of the busy areas of Chennai with this Paris corner, catering to the weaker sections of the community. All in all, MIASI, under its wing, with all its education institutions, has got a student strength of almost 9,000. But you'll all be glad to know that the premier institution with its very good reputation is MIASI Academy of Architecture. And now you are going to be there for the next 5 years. I can assure you, at the end of it, you will surely be proud of having been a product of MIASI Academy of Architecture. Now, how is that? Let me explain that to you. This institute of architecture is headed by Dr. Altaf, a renowned architect of not only Chennai, Tamil Nadu, but also in India, but also a known name even outside India in the architecture circles. Now, he is an architect who practices by himself, but at the same time, He has been the director of this Academy of Architecture, I think, right since inception. Over this period, he has put in every effort to build up the institution, its infrastructure, and then most importantly, to build up its team, the teaching team, and also the administrative team, and then get all the desired approvals required, and also whatever is required at every stage in terms of not only adding to the infrastructure, adding to the facilities and all that, he not left any stone unturned on getting all those things put in place. Particularly, you will come to know, you would have already seen in your interviews and all that, the quality of this person, the quality of the management, the people who have interviewed you, along with Altaf Bhai, I have also been involved in those interviews, and we have done our best to select the best amongst the interviewees. Also, primarily you should understand that this is a minority institution, and we have given preference to in the selection of the minority students, which is mainly the Muslim students, okay, who are in the weaker sections or whatever it is, we try to support them, and we have got them also in the management quota. Maybe 50% of it is by the weaker sections of the minority community. Having said that, while trying to select from the minority community, we have not compromised on the quality. And that quality will be taken care of not only at the point of admission, but also during the running of the course of these 5 years. Now, how that will happen? That will happen because the faculty that is there, we have got today for teaching and for training you all. I think is amongst the best, if not the best, amongst all the architecture institutes of the city, certainly, of Tamil Nadu also, I would say certainly, also amongst India, that faculty will qualify amongst the best. Now, this faculty has been selected on merit, and they have been trained in a very hard manner to give the best to you all. And not only that, we have got a lot of visiting faculty who are practicing architects, and many of our faculty also may be practicing on their own. But since the location of this institute is in the heart of the city, and also because of the reputation of the institutes, many qualified architects want to join this institute for giving the benefit of their knowledge to students like you all. And there have been, many of them have been here for many years, and they have also done their masters, and they have been coming here to teach you. We have got many visiting faculty, as I told you, who have also got years of experience. For them also, it is easier to come here and teach due to the location and also due to the reputation. So, you will find that you will get the best teaching and training over the next 5 years. Now, everything doesn't depend only on what you get from the teachers. A lot depends on you. That's why we have selected you all very carefully. But the inputs on a subject of architecture, which I understand, I am not an architect myself, but what I have understood over the last 3 or 4 years of my being one of the key administrators of MIASI, is that that this course of architecture involves a lot of practical application, which means that along with the theory, you have to put in a lot of hours of work on practical application, on your drawings, on your plans, and then visits to various areas which we'll all be organizing for you all. And that it also includes, we have some link-ups with foreign universities. Some of them, some of you all are selected to go abroad to just visit those places and come back and understand some of the things better. You may have to present papers there along with your teachers. So, all this kind of training will be available for you, but how much you get out of it depends a lot on you. Of course, the institute is not going to leave you just like that. They are going to drive you and only in your interest. And if you really, all of you, take it very seriously, you will get the maximum out of this. So today you are all coming to the institute, starting your activity here, and along with all this, the other important thing that the institute imparts is discipline and proper Indian ethos and culture. This also is imparted to you all in a very uncompromising, strict manner. So, please, you all can have your good times, there is no doubt about it. In institution, you will have, you may have to be with your colleagues and all that kind of thing. You may, in your free time, you may have your other sources of entertainment and all that. But I'm telling you that time of yours will be very less. Because if you really are serious and if you focus on the course, the time to be spent on the course will be much more than what you all feel. So, what I would say is, these 5 years, your parents are spending so much money on you. Yeah, Miyazaki Academy of Architecture may be costlier than the other institutes, but you know, for quality, there is a cost. And the institute is incurring a lot of cost to maintain that quality. And you all, at the end of it, you'll all, your parents will be very happy they got you all into this institute, though it is at a higher cost. So, my dear young friends, please take the maximum out of the Miyazaki Academy of Architecture. Please utilize this opportunity that has been given to you to get instituted in this institute, even in a very difficult year. You will be glad to note that Miyazaki Academy of Architecture has been, we have at least 5 to 6 times the number of applications against the seats that we had. So, your selection, you can understand how difficult it would have been. So, I really welcome you all to the institute. Wish you all the best. Put in all your best efforts. Become the best architects in India and maybe internationally also. And not only architects, you will definitely be the best, among the best citizens of India, and performing a good role of contributing the maximum to the country. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable speech. Inspirational address by Vice President Janab T. Rafiq Ahmed Sahib. Janab T. Rafiq Ahmed Sahib, Managing Trustee of T. Abdul Wahid Charitable Foundation, the social arm of T. Abdul Wahid Group of Industries, which promotes women's education and employment. He is a member of the Executive Council for Justice Bashir Ahmed Said College for Women, formerly SIET College. He is also the president of Anjuman-e-Himayat-e-Islam. He is also the vice president of the Muslim Educational Association of Southern India. We request our Honorable Vice President, Janab T. Rafiq Ahmed Sahib, to deliver his inspirational address.
respected President, Prince of Arcad, Nawab Muhammad Abdul Ali Nazim Jah, the Honorary Secretary, Janab Ilyas Seth Sahib, the Director of Miyasi Academy of Architecture, Professor Altaf Ahmed Sahib, all the faculty members, and my dear students. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi barakatuhu, and a greetings from Miyasi Academy of Architecture. First of all, see, I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you all to this first day of your college, and also congratulate you for having been selected as a student of this institute. You are aware, our institute, Miyasi Academy of Architecture, is the best in the state of Tamil Nadu and also one of the best in the country. We have been selected for your meritorious performance, hence I regard you as one of the best batch who have come to this institution again to get knowledge on architecture. Our endeavor is to give you the best. In this, we are discussing a collaboration with the Department of Planning, University of Johannesburg, South Africa, and also we have various programs which we want to do it online to give you better exposure. My dear students, you have come here to become a successful architect and gain knowledge. At the same time, apart from your studies which you will be doing here, I would advise you to look around in the city of Chennai itself. There are beautiful buildings in and around Chennai. During the interview, we found that many of the students were not even aware of such beautiful buildings in Chennai. Just to give you an example, the British age buildings like the Egmore Station, the Central Railway Station, the Southern Railway's office, the High Court building, the University of Madras on the marina, and many buildings on the beach side, apart from temples, churches, and the mosques, which are in city itself or in Tamil Nadu. Hence, I would advise you to go around the city and look at these marvels which have been created a few hundred years back, but still today we are admiring for such architectural beauty. But coming back to present age, you are here to serve the people of India. India, with a large population, needs housing for every individual families. Hence, they are looking for affordable dwellings so that they can afford the cost, at the same time have a home of their own. Hence, making the projects in future, we have to keep in mind the utility point of view of the project, at the same time the cost factor. At the same time, you will come across many rich people who would like to have the best in design, the luxury, the best modern amenities. All these are their requirement. And for them, you see, the cost is not a factor, but they are looking for something unique and best. That also will be an opportunity for you to show your talents. I'm also happy to inform you that this year again, our students have obtained university rank. More than 10 students have obtained the university rank in BR. At the same time, in the MR also we have obtained the ranks. This shows our students' ability and the hard work what our faculty have done. Here in this institute, the Academy of Architecture, in the next 5 years, you will be getting the knowledge how to do projects to meet the requirement of various sector of people, the various sector of department. Hence, you should have that aptitude to learn the knowledge. You should not just spend your time attending the classes, but you must have that inherent knowledge, the inherent ability to look around and learn something from every project what you see. I don't want you to go to abroad and learn immediately, but with, as I said, Chennai is a beautiful city. It has got marvelous buildings. Apart from that, modern buildings also have come up. So these things you have to take advantage and try to learn what is best for the people. So hence I welcome you all for this next 5 years course, which we will be doing in our Academy of Architecture. Your parents have sent you to this institute to get the best. They are spending a huge amount of money on you with the hope that you become the best architect and be of useful to others and for yourselves. And I wish you all the best in this next coming 5 years, and I advise you to concentrate in these courses. This is not an easy one. 5 years you have to work hard to get through. But once you get through, you've got a great future, because India, which is already a developed country and also developing, there is a potential to develop further, has got lot of opportunity which you will come across to show your talents. Hence, with these few words, again I welcome you all to this institute, Miyasi Academy of Architecture, and wish you all the best. Jai Hind, Allah Hafiz.
Thank you, sir, for the highly inspiring talk.
Inspirational address by Honorable Treasurer Janab Najimuddin Majid. Janab Najimuddin Sahib is the Honorary Treasurer of Miyasi. He is a person driven by a deep desire to solve social and economical problems and help others, especially the economically weaker sections of the society. A well-known philanthropist, Janab Najimuddin is a hotelier with various other business interests. He is also a member of many associations and charitable organizations. We request our Honorable Treasurer, Janab Najimuddin Sahib, to deliver his inspirational address.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning to all. Respected President, Honorary Secretary, Board Members of Miyasi, Academy of Architecture, the Director, parents, students and all others. I welcome and greet all the students to our prestigious Miyasi Academy of Architecture. We have one of the best faculty efficiently managed by the director, Mr. Altaf Sahib, and his resolute team. Miyasi Architecture is one of the top architectural institutions in India. We ensure that students will be taken diligent care of, not only in academics, but we are also shape them to be good human beings and good citizens of the great nation. I wish each one of you good luck and best wishes to all.
Thank you, sir, for your inspirational address.
Special address by guest of honor, Professor Vijay Shri Krishna Sohoni, past president, Council of Architecture. Vijay Shri Krishna Sohoni completed his graduation from Bombay University in the year 1973 and post-graduation also from Bombay University in 1987. He started his architectural practice in the year 1973. In his academic journey, he has held several responsibilities. Principal at College of Architecture, Nashik from 1989 to 2006. Director at Vidyavardhan's Institute of Design, Environment and Architecture, Goa from 2006 to 2011. Director at Vidyavardhan's Institute of Design, Environment and Architecture, Nashik from 2011 to 2018, to name a few. He has also worked on various bodies of Pune University, YCMO University, IGNO and DBATU. He was instrumental in starting B-Design programs in interior design, product design, set design and furniture design in Pune University. He was also the Vice President of the Council of Architecture from 2001 to 2004 and also the President of the Council of Architecture from 2004 to 2012. Professor Sohoni introduced NATA, National Aptitude Test for Architecture, created NIASA, National Institute of Advanced Studies in Architecture, teachers training workshops, thesis award program and publication of books at COA. He also introduced master's courses at 50 plus centers in India and contributed immensely in the complete computerization at COA. Some of his notable professional work include Chambers for Advocates, Nagji Memorial Hospital at Nashik, Raj Bahadur Hospital and Cardiac Care Center, Nashik, Athre Patel Memorial Hospital at Ahmednagar, Slum Improvement Scheme at Eranwadi Panchavati, Nashik under Valmiki Ambedkar Housing Scheme and Kusum Raj Memorial at Nasik. Professor Sohoni has done and directed various research works, out of which some important ones are traffic survey for Nashik City, national and international urban slums, finding appropriate construction techniques for the same, heritage listing for Nashik City, creating a hierarchical signage system for Nashik City. His other interests include theater, music, arts, literature, and travel. It is our pleasure to invite our guest of honor, Professor Vijay Shri Krishna Sohoni, to deliver the special address.
Hello. Namaste. Vanakkam. At the outset, let me congratulate all of you young students for getting in one of the prestigious institutes in the field of architectural education. I must also congratulate you on selecting architecture as a discipline. Architecture is something very special. It's very different from the other disciplines, the other professional streams that we come across. And what is so different about architecture? Let's look at it. In all other disciplines, there is a time to work and there's time to play. Architecture is probably the only discipline where work is play and play is work. So every moment for the next 5 years when you study architecture, and then later on, all the time that you may spend in your profession is going to be a time to enjoy, a time to explore, a time to engage with what is all around you and get great pleasure out of it. That is the difference between architecture and other disciplines. You are now going into a phase of life which is very different from what you are accustomed to till your 12th. Because you remember that when you studied in your earlier years, whatever content was taught to you, there was a problem that each one of you had to attempt, and the solution that you came about with was the same for everyone. But in architecture, whatever you do, if there are 40 people in class, then each one of you are going to come out with a unique solution to every problem. Your solutions cannot be the same, they have to be different. And that is something which is very different from what you are accustomed to earlier. Earlier, 2 plus 2 were always 4. Now 2 plus 2 need not be 4, it could be 3, it could be 2.5, and you can come out with your own take, and each solution, each effort that you put in is going to be judged independently. The judgment is not peer level judgment. Your work is not going to be compared with somebody else's work. It is going to be compared with your own work. Your own endeavor is going to be tested against whether you have done your best or could you have done better. So this is a very different approach in learning. This is a very different approach in the whole teaching learning process or the learning teaching process. So some of you may take a little bit of time to understand what is going on, but this is what it is. And this is very different. Let me quickly talk to you about what is architecture, because in the society at large, architecture is a word which is completely misunderstood. In fact, the laypersons tend to use the word architect, contractor, builder, civil engineer, mistry, all of these words as if they are synonym, as if they mean one and the same. But that's not correct. All these different stakeholders in the building industry have their own role to play. But very importantly, the role of the architect is of prime importance. In fact, the driver of the building industry is the architect or architectural practice. Like I can say that you are the Thalaiwa of construction industry. Take a Rajinikanth movie. If you remove Rajinikanth from the movie, there is nothing left in it, right? Similarly, in a construction project, if the architect is taken away, then there's nothing left in the project. So your responsibility is the prime responsibility in any construction project that comes about. And there are multiple types of construction projects. Most importantly, there are the residential projects. You know, there are three things that we talk about that human beings need. They need shelter, they need food, and they need clothes, right? So these are the basic needs of the human beings. Shelter, which is the basic need, is provided by an architect. Of course, there are other people who work with him, but as I said in the beginning, the primary role is that of an architect to create some kind of a shelter for the human being. And it's not only a shelter, it's a shelter which has to be comfortable, which has to protect the human being against various natural forces. And you don't stop there, because merely providing a roof over somebody's head is just the beginning of architecture. Along with that, the place, in addition to being comfortable, has to be beautiful, has to be good to look at. So there is this whole question of aesthetics. That is why we say that architecture is an amalgam or a mixture of both technology and aesthetics. It has to look good and it has to feel good. It has to be done, it has to satisfy the body, the bodily comfort, as well as the heart and the mind. And that is why the architect's role becomes very important. Okay, traditionally, architecture has been defined in many ways, but the definition that I like the most is it is frozen music. So you can see, architecture is not merely a technological output in terms of a building which is constructed, but it has to satisfy the senses of the people who use these buildings. Okay, now all this means that in order to become an architect, you have to study different streams. So let's quickly look at what you are likely to study in the next 5 years. The whole curriculum of architecture is divided into basically four verticals. The first one deals with skills. Okay, and one of the important skills that you will have to learn is the skill of representing what you want in form of some kind of a drawing. Now, the drawing could be made on a piece of paper or it could be made on the screen of a computer. Okay, but you will have to learn the skill of presenting your ideas through your drawings. Now, once again, let's see that there is one myth, and that people are born artists, or some people are born with the skill of drawing, and that's absolute rubbish. I can tell you that the skill of drawing is a skill which anybody and everybody can learn. It's just like, so everybody knows how to walk. Everybody can learn to use a bicycle. Everybody can learn to swim. Similarly, everybody can learn to draw. Now, you all know that when you try to learn to ride a bicycle, some people learn it in 5 minutes. Some people take 5 days, bruise their knees, fall down 20 times. But finally, everyone can learn how to ride a bicycle. Similarly, if you want to learn the skill of drawing, then it is possible for everyone to learn. It may take some people very little time to learn the skill. For some people, it may take a little more time. But this whole method of expressing your ideas through drawings is very important to architects. Why is it important? Because drawing is a language that we use to communicate with others. And this language is very different from other languages. You know, suppose let's say I want to talk to you in Tamil, then I must know Tamil and you must also know Tamil, right? Only then we can have a conversation. If I want to speak to you or convey something to you in Hindi, then both of us must know Hindi. So, in most languages, it is both the people who are communicating need to know the language. Drawing is probably the only language where only one who wants to communicate has to know how to draw. The person that I am trying to communicate with need not know how to draw, and he will still understand what I am saying. So you can understand that this language of drawing is a very powerful drawing. A very powerful language. Anybody can understand what you have drawn, if you have drawn it well, obviously. And therefore, it is at times called as the universal language. And the first thing that you will learn probably is the skill of communicating with others through your skills of drawing. But remember, this is only a skill. Now, along with this skill, there may be other skills related to communicating verbally, communicating in written form, because when you practice as an architect, it is not merely the drawings that will be sufficient, but you'll have to deal with people. So communications is a very important skill that architects must have. But beyond that, the remaining, you know, things which are put in these four verticals that I was talking about are very important. The first one deals with technology. You know, if you're going to construct buildings, they will require some kind of technology. There will be the construction of buildings, the various materials that you use. There will be various kinds of services that are required, the electricity, water supply, etc., etc. These are all technical subjects. You will also have to learn a bit of structures, theory of structures or mechanics. So these, all these we put in the first box, which is called as the technology box. Okay. And you will learn this probably for all the first 3 or 4 years. Along with this, there is the second box, which is the humanities box. A lot of people ask this question. Why is it that architects should study history? Why should they study sociology? What is their role? Or how is all this connected with their role as an architect? And very simply, let's understand that when you construct a building, it is going to be used by somebody. And just as we say that when you go to a tailor and get a dress stitched, it has to fit you, right? And everybody's bodies are different. So you need to get dresses which are differently made for everyone. You cannot use somebody else's dress very easily. Of course, you can use it, but it will not fit you well. Okay. Similarly, when you make buildings, they are to be used by different types of users. And what you have to be aware of is whether the building suits the requirements, the purpose, the functions, or the aspirations of the user. And therefore, you have to learn to study the user. And when you study the user, when you want to study the people who are going to occupy your buildings, then you need to know about many things. You need to know about the anthropometry of the user. You have to know about the culture. You have to know about his habits. You have to know about the way he uses his spaces all around, his ethnicity, the climate in which you are going to use that building. Obviously, a building which is constructed, let's say, in Chennai, with the kind of water logging that you just had in the last period of receding monsoons, there your buildings will have to be different than, let's say, a building constructed in Rajasthan in the desert. There the climatic situation is going to be different. So the ethnicity of the user is also very important. You know, how we use spaces depends a lot on what kind of lifestyle that we are accustomed to as users. So as an architect, you need to not only study the technology of construction of a building, but you need to also have the wherewithals or the skill sets to study the user, understand the user, and then design the building. It's like kind of saying that you have to enter into the shoes of the users. You have to imagine as if you are the user and you are going to use the space, the building, the shelter, whatever you may call it, and design it to suit that particular purpose. So the subjects related to humanity, subjects related to social sciences become equally important. Because remember, we are not only creating the box, because the box needs to hold the content, and the content is the user, right? Then all this has to be practiced as a profession of architecture. So there are professional skills which are required. There are subjects or courses like estimating the cost of the building. How much is it going to cost once it is constructed? What kind of laws will apply? Whether I will need to get permissions from any government agencies? What kind of permissions will be required? So you will have to study all that. Now, this is the professional aspect. There is also the whole question of how you deal with various stakeholders, the users, the clients, the contractors, the municipal authorities, etc., etc. So there are a whole set of stakeholders in the building industry, and how do you deal with each one of them is also part of your professional practice studies. So there are subjects related to professional practice. That is the third box. And then we will come to the most important box, and that is to take everything from each of these three boxes that we talked about, use the skills that you have learned, and with all this, come out with a design solution. Now, when you talk of design solution, you are actually talking about something which is the core of architectural practice. Architecture is actually a problem-solving exercise all the time. Usually, and the design studios, which will occupy probably one third of all your time in your college, you are given a problem to solve. And the problem is designing and construction of some kind of a building. And you will have to study the type of building, the kind of technology required. You will need to study the user who is going to use this building or for whom the building is going to be designed. You will need to bring in your professional skills and then use the other skill sets like drawing that you have learned and come out with a design solution. And when we talk of the design solution, it is important to understand that there are several layers of satisfaction that is required from your design solutions. The first one obviously is the physical requirement. Suppose you are asked to design a chair, then the chair must allow you to sit, right? So that is a physical requirement. And then there is the whole requirement of the technology required, you know, technology to be used, the materials to be used to make the chair, etc. So that's the first one. Then they say there is the secondary. Even though I say secondary, it doesn't mean it is not as important as the first one. It is the second type of satisfaction that one has to look for from your design solution. And that is the emotional satisfaction. Okay. Now, what is this emotional satisfaction? You see, we have five senses. Human beings have been given five senses and we sense everything with the help of these. We see things, we hear things, we touch things, we taste them, and obviously, most importantly, we see them. Okay, so these are these five senses that I'm talking about. Now, whatever you design has to also satisfy all these five senses. Only then it will become a successful design. And at the tertiary level or the third level, which is a very difficult level to achieve, you are expected to satisfy the needs which are psychological. You know, I'll just give you an example. You know, the Taj Mahal is considered as a very successful example of a building. Obviously, the first physical satisfaction is that it has to cover the mausoleum. Ensure that the mausoleum is protected against rain and sun, etc., etc. And that is something that is obviously done, right? The jo cover hai, usko to cover ho gaya. That's very easy. Secondly, it has to satisfy the senses. When you look at the Taj, you feel so nice. It is beautiful to look at, etc., etc. So the second level of satisfaction is also very easily done. But let's look at the third level of satisfaction. What is the third level of satisfaction? It has to convey an idea, the idea of somebody's eternal love for his wife. Now, that is very difficult to convey. That is very difficult to, bring out through your design solution. But a successful design must try to do all this. It must satisfy the physical needs, then the sensory needs or the psychological needs. And thirdly, it must also be able to communicate an idea to the people. Now, all this is something that we tend to learn to do as architects in the 5 years. I'm sure you have good teachers, so at the end of 5 years, you should be able to do all this without any problems. Here, I would pause and look at what the future holds for you. You know, because after all, after completing these 5 years, you want to know what you want to do. So to start with, let me say that your bachelor's degree in architecture is just a stepping stone. Once you finish this, then there is a whole lot of specialization available to you. You can choose to be an architect. You can choose to do work as a landscape architect. You could choose to do interiors. You could choose to get into urban design. You could choose to go and become a product designer. You can get into, maybe there are hundreds and hundreds of disciplines which you can get into later on. I have known people who have joined IIMs and become very successful managers. And in fact, one of the IIT professors that I met once told me that architects are very good managers. And I asked him why. So he says, because unlike others, they are already taught to think out of the box. You know, he says that when I get an engineer who joins an IIM at Ahmedabad, then he is taught to, you know, use a single line logic. While as an architect, you are taught to think out of the box. Because I told you in the beginning that every solution is unique. It is your own solution. So similarly, even while dealing with management, architects are found to be better suited to think out of the box and come out with dramatically different solutions to a management problem. Similarly, architects always tend to be very good team leaders. So even if you take up a job anywhere, you will very easily be able to lead a team. Because as an architect, when you work, you are expected to work with many different consultants. You know, there is an RCC guy, there will be a man on site, there could be a clerk, or there would be a municipal guy, and you have to learn to deal with all of them simultaneously and take into account many things that dovetail into your design solution. So inherently you are taught to be a leader, and therefore that will help you in your future certainly. There are also very, you know, off the track ways in which you could work later on. For instance, you could write. Architectural journalism is also very popular. You could become a conservation architect. You know, India has a tremendous potential of conservation of old architectural edifices, and there is a need for people to become conservationists. You could become actually a very good, an advocate of new ideas, you know, advocacy, or becoming some kind of a firebrand leader is something that architects tend to do very well. You'll be surprised to know that I know many people who have become politicians, very successful politicians, who are actually architects. Anyway. That is a little far-fetched for the time being. But what I'm saying is, after you finish your bachelor's, it is not necessary that you only work as an architect. There are many other avenues open to you. You know, some people could go and design sets for films. Some could, get into gaming. You know, the other day I met an old student of mine, and I asked him, what is he doing? So he says, he's designing sets for the games. So I said, what sets for the games? So he said, sir, you don't know. There are people who play these all kinds of video games. They said, sir, have you realized that there's an environment? There's something behind the game. The game is set into some kind of a, scenario. And somebody has to create that scenario, even the visuals for the scenario. And he says, I do that. So I was quite surprised. I didn't realize that architects can even get into, you know, gaming or making games, which is a big industry. You all know that. So all in all, I would say that getting into architecture or making it your choice of profession in the first place was something which you have chosen well. And that's why I said I must congratulate you in the beginning, right? As far as the next 5 years are concerned, once again, I wish you very well. I'm sure that you will enjoy these 5 years, and you'll also keep on enjoying for the rest of your life. Okay? Thank you. And I must thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to talk to you.
Thank you for your motivating address, sir.
Address by Dean Professor Dr. A.N. Sachidanandan. Our Dean, Professor Dr. A.N. Sachidanandan, will share his views on the academic strength and laurels of a college.
Welcome to Vinyasa Academy. I have great pleasure in making a presentation on how things happen in Vinyasa. We believe teachers are basic resources. They have various specializations and master's degrees such as 3DF Architecture, Construction Technology and Management, Urban Design, Architectural Pedagogy, sustainability, IGBC lead certification experts, and BIM, facade and frame controls, and it goes on. They have done their specialization in institutions of the group, from UK, USA, China, and also institutions like SET, Ahmedabad, SPA Delhi, IIT, and Anna University, to mention a few. In addition to that, further deans and very senior faculty are brought in into the teaching fold, and they who have been members of the Board of Studies are able to add value to the subjects that are taught. Anna University had used the exclusive expertise available in real estate for framing the syllabus and subjects in master's degree of real estate planning, which is the capping of the terms available at NYASA. What is the impact of these things in our performance of the students? Students of NYASA has hit a century in 2020 by taking 101 ranks at the Anna University from its inception. And this year, in 2020, they got 10 ranks, including the first rank of architect Tanuja with 9.22 rank. And overall results of BRH runs around 98% on first attempt within 5 years. That is how we operate. I'd like to make a mention of some of our faculty members who have been drawn from former CMDA, member secretary of CMDA, and then deans of Anna University, and very senior practicing architects and administrators from CPWD are all part of our institution. The students thus have been able to achieve front position in the world of Tamil Nadu and at the Avindya level. First place, exemplary performance on competition by Square D Factor 2019, international level, FAB Festival in 2018 and 19, they had overwhelming races. First, in the public appreciation record in London, where 15 to 20 students each, years 18 and 17, participated in the fabrication festival at the Westminster University in person, accompanied by two staff members, which made a lot of impact on the standards of students later. There's another mention on latitude project by our institution held at SET University in 2018. The society entry in 2018 also, they won the prize. Our students have been inducted into the CMDA documentation program of Charleston, where they have shown this to the public, and also by making the presentation, they are appreciated by the senior officials of the CMDA. All these things are possible because of the consistent adhesion by the staff members, and it is coupled by the induction of only 35 practicing senior architects who take the time to help the students and come guide them in their design, dissertation, thesis, and they also provide opportunities for them to have visits to hands-on, on-site, completed projects, meeting clients, and then promoters, and learn on first-hand informations. Such publications of members of the staff are mentioned here, and we find that four of our staff members, Professor Riya Sachidharan, Anjali, Anu, Mayan, and Assistant Professor Balaji Mass, have published four presentations each. And also I should mention some of our faculty members, especially Professor Zakir Majidi, has been inducted as a member of the Heritage Committee of the CMDA, which is a credit for not only him, but also for MIASC. And in addition to this, the accreditation program goes on and on. Last year, thanks to the pandemic, there were 40 of the staff members who attended 25 programs conducted by COA and the technical teachers training program of the Board of All India Training. Lastly, coming to the programs of tying up with other universities elsewhere, we have a program of bilateral lecture series of sharing experiences of University of Johannesburg and New York Institute of Technology, which have produced two lectures from the foreign university and three of our staff members, namely Professor Riya Sachidharan, Professor Joseph, and Professor Sunya, have made presentations for the international students. We believe in comprehensive, casual, and contextual learning. The comprehensive learning takes place in the classrooms with teacher-student interactions. Casual learning, more of learning, happens in the library, lobby, veranda, staircase, and canteen. And contextual learning, experience shared by the various architects. And with this background, I would like to say that the contact and the good relationship we have maintained, the director has maintained with Council of Architecture, the various vice chancellors of Anna University, has helped us grow in size and fame, and we thank all these people and our resourceful management for helping us in all our activities. I take this opportunity to congratulate you for having taken the right step in coming to MIASC, and hope you will enjoy your stay here and prosper in your life. Thank you. And a word of special mention for the parents, to encourage them towards to make the best of the resources available at MIASC. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Address by HOD, Professor Kesavlu. We request our head of the department, Professor S. Kesavlu, to address the students and invitees on discipline and student welfare of our college.
Welcome to 23rd Induction Day program. Yes, this is 23rd Induction Day program. There has been a phenomenal growth of this institution since 1999 in terms of faculty strength, facilities, and student intake. Student intake has increased from 15 to 160 per batch, faculty from 5 to 73 full-time staff, apart from host of part-time faculty. Infrastructure from modest building to a three-storied front block, rear block, and annex with state-of-the-art CAD lab, auditorium, and library. You would have seen all this in the video. The strength of this institution lies with academically strong faculty and dedicated students. You are joining this institution after a tough competition to add to the standard, credibility, strength and reputation of this college. From school education, you are entering into professional education. That requires maturity of mind and attitude to learn. All of you have gone through NATA examination and therefore you have the aptitude to study architecture. Your learning experience does not take place only within four walls of classroom or studio. During pandemic period, we have been having virtual classes for theory courses. You should develop a habit of interaction with your faculty in the class and outside the class, intercommunicate with your peers, keenly take note of the development taking place in the field of architecture outside, articulate what you have designed, listen to audiovisual presentation, make web case study and case studies at the site, participate in seminars and workshops, visit work sites and spend time in the library. You can also participate in national and international competitions. You have the freedom of choosing professional electives, web-based courses during your 5 years of study. Initially, we will conduct theory classes online and basic design and architectural drawing classes offline due to pandemic restrictions. In course of time, we may have mostly offline classes by which you can interact with faculty better in the class. Our students have been scoring top ranks in ANA University examinations consistently for the last few years. Last year, that is in April-May 2020 examination, top 10 ranks in B.Arc and top 2 top ranks in M.Arc were scored. They also won prizes in international competitions held in Westminster University for 3 years continuously. At Miyasi Academy of Architecture, we are insisting on strict discipline. Because of that, many parents are admitting their girls here, and now we have close to 350 girls studying. You should follow a strict code of conduct. All of you must be present at the college at least 10 minutes before the starting time. Follow a decent dress code, wear mask, follow social distancing norms inside the college also, and use hand sanitizers that are kept near the front door. We also have thermal scanners to check your temperature. No student can go out during college hours. Every student is expected to attend all classes and earn 100% attendance. Students who do not satisfy the attendance requirement shall not be permitted to write the end semester examination and shall not be permitted to go to the next semester. You will be assessed by continuous internal assessment and end examination in each subject. Your performance will be monitored continuously and progress reports sent to your parents. We also have a meeting with parents to inform the progress. We'll get your feedback in class committee meetings. There is no ragging taking place in our institution. However, we have a strict vigil on ragging and follow UGC guidelines on this. We have formed an anti-ragging squad consisting of senior faculty. According to UGC regulations, all students are required to file anti-ragging affidavit. The anti-ragging committee members are Engineer Leo Lawrence, Associate Professor and Convener, Architect Subhashri, Associate Professor, Architect Suhasini, Associate Professor, Architect Muzakir, GM Bijli, Associate Professor, Dr. S. Nithya, Associate Professor, Architect Sylvinus Glisson, Assistant Professor. You can report to them without any hesitation if there is any such incident. many of our students continue to do their PG programs in India and UK, USA, Italy, Germany, Australia, Singapore, and also work in firms abroad. Some of these alumni will be speaking to you later today about their study here and share their experience abroad. I wish to quote this: success is not accident, it is hard work, perseverance, learning, studying, sacrifice, and most of all, love of what you are doing or learning to do. So, develop the right attitude and passion for learning. In these 5 years of study, you must not only develop knowledge and skills in the area of your study, but also have broad understanding of society and relationships and build your character, which is an essential quality by which you could understand and fulfill your responsibility as an architect. With these few words, let me wish all of you good learning experience in the next 5 years and set higher standards surpassing your seniors.
Thank you, sir.
Address by Principal, Professor Dr. Monsingh B. Devadas. Our principal, Professor Dr. Monsingh B. Devadas, will speak about the curriculum and university regulations.
Good morning. A warm welcome to all of you. At the outset, I would like to join with others to congratulate all the students who have consciously chosen architecture as a professional course for the career. Today marks a significant milestone in your life's journey. According to a recent survey, out of the total Indian population of 1.38 billion, the gross college enrollment ratio is at 26.3%, of which only 0.2% of the students enter professional courses, including architecture. Therefore, you are a privileged one to take this professional course, and more so at Miyasiya Academy of Architecture, which is ranked number one among the private architectural institutions in Tamil Nadu. The BArch degree program is a creative professional discipline defined as art and science of building. In this 5-year BArch degree program, from day one, you will be studying the courses relevant to professional requirements to mold you into an architect. The course content of BArch is based on the new guidelines of Council of Architecture brought out in August 2020. Council of Architecture is a regulatory body for BArch degree program. You will be the first batch of BArch students coming under the Regulation 2021 of Anna University, which is a choice-based credit system. As a member of Board of Studies appointed by VC, we have made few changes in the curriculum and syllabi and regulations when compared to the earlier one. As per the curriculum, every subject is called a course and a minimum of 3 credits. Design Studio, which is drawing-based, ranges from 9 to 14 credits from first semester to 9th semester. Each semester curriculum, except practical training and thesis semester, normally have a blend of 3 to 4 theory courses, 1 to 2 theory cum studio courses, and 1 design studio. The credit assignment is as following. Each course is assigned a certain number of credits based on the following. 1 lecture period is equal to 1 credit. 1 tutorial is equal to 1 credit, and 1 practical or studio period is equivalent to 1 credit, which is a little different from the earlier regulation where it was 2 studio courses equivalent to 1 credit. There are broadly 3 types of courses: theory courses like Introduction to Architecture, Mathematics for Architects, Structural Mechanics, World Architecture, Climate and Built Environment, Water Supply and Sanitation in Buildings, Electricity, Lighting and Acoustics, Specification, Estimation and Budgeting, Professional Practice, Urban Design, Project Management, etc. from first semester to ninth semester. We have the elective courses which will come as part of theory starting from fifth semester to tenth semester. Total number of elective courses available is 24. Theory cum studio, geometrical understanding and representation, building components and representation, thinking through diagrams and models, non-structural building components and finishes, digital drawings, visualization and representation, building construction with basic materials, steel, glass and plastics in building construction, etc. Studio courses are foundation design studio, basic design studio, rural habitats design studio, urban architecture design studio, environmental design studio, critical design studio. Apart from the above, there is practical training at 8th semester where the students will be required to work in a registered architect's firm in any part of India. The culmination of design is a thesis at 10th semester. A total of 276 credits are to be earned in 5 years to get a BA degree. Some of the salient features of regulation of first year BA students under Regulation 21 are: ideally, 100% attendance is required. A minimum of 75% overall attendance is required cumulatively. Study visits, tours are part of the course, which help to consolidate course content by acquiring the students not only with professional practice, but also with the culture and context of the region. Students shall undertake the mandatory educational tour, which is a credited course in the 8th semester. Besides, we have online courses. Student may be permitted a maximum of one online course of 3 credits in lieu of one elective course with the approval of the university. Value-added course. A student can optionally undergo value-added courses in of 1 or 2 credits over and above the credit requirements prescribed by the curriculum, however, not considered for computation of CGPA. Audit course. A student can optionally study audit course prescribed by the university, however not considered for the computation of CGPA. Evaluation system. Each course shall be evaluated for a maximum of 100 marks. The following table explains how weightages are given for various courses. Now we have 4 kinds of categories of courses. Theory courses, including electives, we have 40 marks for continuous internal assessment, and for the university examination, it will be 60 marks. For theory cum studio, for continuous internal assessment, it will be 50, and for the university examination, it will be 50 marks. For studio courses, for the continuous internal assessment, we will have 60 marks, and for the university YOOC examination, it will be 40. And for practical training, dissertation and thesis, it will be 50 marks for continuous internal assessment and 50 marks for the YOOC end semester examination. Requirements for moving to a higher semester. A student of BA shall move to the higher semester if he or she satisfies the following conditions. To move to second semester, a pass is required in Foundation Design Studio in first semester. To move to third semester, a pass is required in Basic Design Studio in second semester. To move to fourth semester, a pass is required in Advanced Space Design Studio in semester 3. To move to fifth semester, a pass is required in Rural Habitat Studio in semester 4. To move to sixth semester, a pass is required in Urban Architecture Design Studio in semester 5. To move to 7th semester, a pass is required in Sustainable Design Studio in semester 6. To move to 8th semester, a pass is required in Critical Design Studio in semester 7. To move to 9th semester, a pass is required in Practical Training in semester 8. To move to 10th semester, a pass is required in Urbanism and Architectural Design Studio in semester 9. In addition, a student shall move to the next higher semester if he or she has satisfied the minimum attendance requirement. A minimum of 50% is required for a pass in internal plus end semester examination or YOOC. Unlike in school, the students will be graded based on the performance. The letter grade A denotes a 10 grade point, A plus denotes 9 grade point, A 8 grade point, B plus 7, B 6, C is 5. And RA stands for reappearance. In case of student failing, they may have to reappear. SA for shortage of attendance, and W for withdrawal. For all the last three categories, the grade point will be zero. When a student secures a CGPA of not less than 8.5, will be declared as first class with distinction. When a student secures a CGPA of not less than 6.5, will be declared as first class. All the other students will qualify for the award of degree, will be declared as second class. At the end of 5 years, we train you to be an architect, licensed to practice architecture anywhere in India. In case you want to specialize after BA, you can do a master's program in architecture or in allied fields. In India, there are about 20 different specializations available in architecture alone, as approved by Council of Architecture. Some of them are general architecture, real estate development, housing, digital architecture, interior design, product design, project management, urban planning, urban design, environmental architecture, heritage conservation, sustainable architecture, etc. You are the 23rd batch of students who are here to set the standards and raise the benchmark of the college. Your 5 years of study will decide your next 50 years of your active professional life. Therefore, put in your best foot forward during your stay in college. Finally, I'd like to say that you are at the right place to make your dream come true. I wish you all a very bright future.
Thank you, sir. We will now be introducing the first year faculty. Foundational Design Studio, Professor Balaji V, Design Chair. Foundational Design Studio, Section A, Architect Divya Lakshmi and Architect Mohammed Mutahir, Assistant Professors. Section B, Architect Sania Afrin, Assistant Professor, Architect Aisha, Assistant Professor. Section C, Architect Premalata, Associate Professor, Architect Nivedita, Assistant Professor. Section D, Architect Anureen Matthews, Assistant Professor, Architect Mohammed Uwais, Assistant Professor. Artist Cognition and Expression, Section A and C, Mr. Saravanan Artist, Architect Radhika Sendhil, Associate Professor and Mentor. Section B and D, Mr. Rajashekar, Artist, Architect Muzaffir Bijli, Associate Professor and Mentor. Geometrical Understanding and Representation, Architect Lokesh, Assistant Professor. Section B, Architect Prasanna Pandian, Assistant Professor. Section C, Architect Anushri, Assistant Professor. Section D, Architect Fabina, Assistant Professor. Introduction to Architecture, A Section, Architect Sai Pooja, Assistant Professor. Section B, Architect Shivakumar, Assistant Professor. Section C, Architect Achilles Sophia, Assistant Professor. Section D, Architect Prasanna Pandian, Assistant Professor. Mathematics for Architects, for all four sections, Mr. Balaji P, Assistant Professor. Introduction to Language and English Skills, for all four sections, Dr. Ravindran, Visiting Faculty. Vote of thanks by Professor M.R. Mohammed Khalid. I invite Professor M.R. Mohammed Khalid, Professor, Niasi Academy of Architecture, to deliver the vote of thanks.
From a very humble beginning, back in the year 1999, with less than 20 students, it has been a wonderful journey for the institution, which now has 40 times more students from where it all started. Growth not only in terms of numbers, but also in the quality and variety of the teaching learning process and dissemination of knowledge. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Good morning to one and all. It gives me immense pleasure to propose the vote of thanks on the occasion of this 23rd induction day of the first year students of BR. Alhamdulillah, I start by thanking the Almighty. It all started with the vision. The person who was behind the exponential growth, which I had just mentioned, with his constant support and guidance, he made sure that no stone is left unturned in making this institution one of repute and one of the most sought-after institutions imparting architectural education in this part of the world. I thank our director, Professor N. Altaf Ahmed, for his welcome address. His Highness, the Prince of Arcot, Janab Nawab Muhammad Abdul Ali Azim Jah Sahib, President of MIASI, who has been a constant support and encouragement for the growth of the institution. I thank you, sir, for your inaugural address. I thank our Honorary Secretary, Janab Elias Seth Sahib, our Vice President, Janab T. Rafiq Ahmed Sahib, and our Honorary Treasurer, Janab Najmuddin Majid Sahib, for their motivational and inspirational speeches. We have been always bestowed upon with the constant support and encouragement of the management in all our endeavors. A big thank you to our management. Our guest of honor, Professor Vijay Sri Krishna Sohoni, for his interesting way of defining the work culture of architects, where he said, "Architecture is the only profession where work is play and play is work." For his comparison of an architect to a superhuman of sorts, to emphasizing on the aspect of architecture as frozen music, and so on. And finally, for throwing light on the various avenues available for the students after graduation. Thank you, sir, for all those words of wisdom and encouragement to the students. I thank our Dean, Professor Dr. A. N. Sachidanandan, for throwing light on the academic strengths and laurels of our institution in his usual impeccable style. I thank Professor S. Kesavalu, our HOD, for his speech on a very important aspect, that of discipline and students' welfare. I thank Professor Dr. Monsingh Devadas, our principal, for explaining the rules and regulations and curriculum of the Anna University. I thank Professor Balaji, the design chair in charge of the first year classes, for putting together the offline activities of the induction program, which will follow in due course. Many thanks to my fellow faculty members. I thank the visiting faculty who have been a constant support all the way. A very special thanks from the bottom of my heart to the induction team, my young and energetic colleagues who worked tirelessly day in and day out to make this program a grand success. I thank our administrative and technical staff members who played a pivotal role in putting together all the things for this event, and the non-teaching staff for the part they have played. I thank the faculty members of all the other institutions who have joined us in this program. I thank all the students and their parents who have made this an event to cherish by their mere presence. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Instruction to the students. All students are required to report on Wednesday, the 24th of November at 8:45 a.m. for the orientation program related activities in MIASI Academy of Architecture campus. Students are also requested to adhere to the COVID protocols while on campus. The material list for regular classes will be mailed to you shortly. Thank you.
I request all of you to kindly stand up for the national anthem.
जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जनगण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।